Hey guys, this is Gaijin Hunter. I apologize for the background b-roll throughout this video, but I still do not know how to use footage from trailers or Netflix shows or films without getting a copyright claim. So sit back and just listen as I give you my spoiler-free review of Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild. It was originally announced for a release in 2019, but for whatever reasons we don't know, it was delayed but finally released today. Legends of the Guild is a 58-minute animated movie by Pure Imagination Studios. This film covers how Aiden, otherwise known to Monster Hunter fans as the Ace Cadet in Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate, or the excitable A-list in Monster Hunter World, came to meet his leader and friend Julius, aka the Ace Commander. So it takes place before Monster Hunter 4, but with references to the events of Monster Hunter World that are yet to occur. From the perspective of a Monster Hunter maniac fan, director Steve Yamamoto, producer Dave Coleman, and writer Joshua Fine must have either been really good at doing their research or their Monster Hunter fans to begin with, because the film is filled to the brim with references to the game in a way that goes way beyond just having some fun shoutouts here and there. It literally is the entire film. It is a love letter to Monster Hunter fans, and this is the stories we've always wanted. Something that takes place in the world of Monster Hunter and focuses on the drama that everyday hunters would naturally come up against. As for the characters, the film does a really good job. Aiden is likable and we get more insight into his character development, including his tendency to use monster puns, his overall background story, and more. Julius is as socially awkward as always, and a cast of supporting characters are all fun and unique. I especially love the feline named Nox. He steals just about every scene he was in, and the comic relief he has was always on point. I really like how Capcom has been committed to fleshing out the Ace Hunters as characters in the franchise, and I hope we see more of this going forward. You know, I kind of understand why they did this format, because they didn't know how Monster Hunter back then would translate into such a huge franchise in the West. But I kind of wish that they had more faith and they committed this to, you know, making an entire series. I hope this film particularly is successful and well received so that they actually consider doing this. Every character had a backstory that was just begging to be jumped into deeper for as like its own episode. And I do feel that fans who played Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate and World will get pretty much all the backstory hints, but someone who isn't that familiar with the series may gloss over some of these, and it may have been better to jump into these in a more deeper format. That being said, at 58 minutes, it also means the pacing is very fast. It's very easy to just watch this thing, so no boring moments or scenes that play out longer than they should. In the best meaning of the phrase, it left me wanting more. Music felt on point, and while I didn't hear any like tunes lifted from the game, there were arrangements of some very familiar songs that were highly enjoyable. Monster-wise, they did a really good job of picking the ones that they did, and I especially love the care that was put in to show off the characteristics of the monsters as we know them from the game, and taking some of their quirks and making them something actually involved with the plot of the film. I won't go into which monsters appear, as I think that would be a spoiler, but needless to say, all of them were very fun. If I could offer any surface level critiques, it would be that the battle scenes do feel a little weird, in that it has this effect that it almost looks like sped up animation, but I kind of think that this is a studio style rather than anything else, so I think it'll just be like you like it or you don't. But the actual events and the pacing of the battles I liked quite a bit, so it didn't bother me that much. The visual design though does have the feeling of the old cutscenes in the series, and the overall just direction is very authentic. The monsters and locations were all beautifully imagined, and when it comes down to the voices of the characters, I watched this in Japanese. It was a dub from the English version with English subtitles so that my daughter Yuna could enjoy it as well. I didn't watch it in English yet, I will, but for what I've seen, the English is really good, and the Japanese dub was fantastic. One of the other critiques, I guess, would be the sudden shifts in tone. In a way, this is perhaps unavoidable because of the breadth of the story that they're trying to tell within 58 minutes, but the tone can go from very soft and funny to dark and serious pretty fast. This is where I think it would have been not as abrupt had they committed to making this into a multiple episode series versus a shorter film. Still, the dark moments do make sense, unlike the Hollywood movie, and it does give you an appreciable perspective that monsters are actually dangerous, and that we aren't just superheroes going around slaying them for fun. There are tons of interesting lore implications and callouts and other background story elements I would love to talk about, but I'll save that for a spoiler review at a later date after I have a chance to watch the film a few more times. That's right, I'm gonna watch this a few more times. I really enjoyed it. I love the film, and it really hit all the notes I wanted from a Monster Hunter film. Yuno also very much enjoyed this, which is surprising because she's someone who typically does not like watching films. I hope you enjoyed hearing my thoughts on it, and if you're a Monster Hunter fan, especially one that knows the characters from Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate, I think it's worth subbing to Netflix just for a month just to see this. Great job to the studio and Capcom on the achievement here. I hope it's well received, and I would love to see a series made by the same team. Anyways, that's the end of my review. I'm not going to go into any more details. Hope you guys enjoyed it as well. Do not leave any spoilers in the comments below, but do let me know what you thought of the film if you saw it. Hope you guys enjoyed this, and until next time, happy watching.